Hello guys, this is Vaish from Vaish IAS and we are going to continue the HITS History NCERT series. We are doing class 9th now. Okay, and I told you it's about a little bit of world history, then the peasant and the tribal revolt in India, and then about some evolution of sports and cloth in different parts of the world. Okay, that is the whole gist of class 9th textbook. So, French Revolution and Russian Revolution is the chapter 1 and 2, and now it is chapter 3. That is about the rise of Hitler and Nazism. So there is a lot of details and it's a very big chapter. So we'll directly start without much other discussion today. Okay, so this, let me just zoom in, sorry. Okay, Nazism and the rise of Hitler. Okay, so here first, like this textbook always does, it is telling the whole gist in just one paragraph and then only it will go to the actual history. Okay. So it's telling about 1945, you know, 1945 World War is getting over and Hitler also will die by that time. So they're telling about the story, okay. A little 11-year-old German boy called Helmut was lying in bed when he overheard his parents discussing something in serious tones. His father, a prominent physician, deliberated with his wife whether the time had come to kill the entire family or he should commit suicide alone. So some problem was there, and it's a typical German family at that time. Okay, what was happening in that time? To get the feel of that, only the story is told. Okay, Allies. What is Allies? Allies is the group of UK, USA, USSR, and France. Okay, so these were the Allies, and the opposite side will be Axis powers, the Germany, Japan, and Italy. Okay, this is about the Second World War I'm talking about. In the First World War, it was a different naming. It was like Central powers versus the Allied forces. So this was happening, and that father actually shot himself dead, and that child did not know what to do, and even child left the home because he felt like his mother will poison him. Okay, this was the situation there in Germany that time. And then his father was a Nazi supporter. Okay, that is under Adolf Hitler. We'll see what is Nazi and how Adolf Hitler will rise to power. So this is how the story begins. By telling about the life of the people there, okay, the killing of Jews. There are a lot of atrocities which happened during Hitler's regime. Okay, here you can see Hitler along with his minister. Okay, this particular picture. In 1945, the World War ended actually, and Germany surrendered to the Allies. And Hitler and his minister, who we see in picture, Goebbels. Okay, they both committed suicide. Okay, the entire family committed suicide in the Berlin bunker in April. That is what, that is how Hitler's life ended, or the World War II ended. Now we have to zoom into the entire thing. Okay, how the story happened. Okay, this is all is again about the genocide killing. That is, you know, genocidal. Okay, killing of large number of people together. Okay, that is genocide which Hitler did in huge numbers. So that is the story we are going to study. So we learned from the 1914, that is from the around the time of World War. So Germany, a powerful empire in the early years of the 20th century, fought the World War alongside Austrian Empire and against the Allies. So again, if you see Allies, that time is England, France and Russia, and last minute USA also will join in. So Austria was a superpower that time, okay, in terms of this kind of war and all. And all joined the war enthusiastically, hoping to gain from a quick victory. So everybody thought like, okay, we'll become the supreme power, we'll quickly finish off this war. But it went for 4 or 5 years, okay. You know, World War I, 1914 to 1918. World War related thing will come in different classes, okay, I think class 11th. But now we have to understand the story from the German perspective, okay. This chapter is about German perspective. So Germany initially made gains by occupying France and Belgium. Okay, map I'll show you. And Allies strengthened by US entry in 1917, won actually, and defeated Germany and all the central powers. I told you, right, central powers it is called in the First World War. Okay, second it is called the Axis powers. In the Second World War, the same group is called the Axis powers. The others is always Allied powers only, Allied. Now, Imperial Germany was defeated, and there will be actually a humiliating treaty called the Versailles Treaty also, which you will learn in the World War I chapter. So, a National Assembly met at Weimar, and Weimar is actually their constitution kind of thing, okay, and established a democratic constitution with a federal structure. Deputies were now elected to the German parliament or Reichstag. Okay, Reichstag is actually the name of the parliament they have. Every country has different names for the parliament. Try to find out whenever you have time. Okay, on the basis of equal and universal votes cast by all adults, including women. Okay, so this is what happened to the German polity, you can tell, after the World War I. Now, the Republic, however, was not received well by its own people, largely because of its terms it was forced to accept under Germany's defeat. So, I told you there was a peace treaty which was called Versailles Treaty, that is Versailles Palace in France, you can tell. There, a very humiliating treaty was there in which the defeated powers were totally made to agree to a lot of conditions. So the people of Germany were not at all happy with the German regime or the German Reichstag, okay, the parliament. So I'll tell you what were the provisions of that. Before that, you can see the map. If you see, this is the key of the map. You can see a land taken away from Germany is in this kind of a pink orange kind of color. Okay, you can see these places were taken away. This Rhineland place, which was under Germany, was made to be demilitarized. Like that cannot army cannot be placed here. So a lot of places were exchanged. France took away a lot of places, and all this will actually result in the Second World War also later. Okay, Hitler will rise and he will be leading it, and then it is a kind of revenge story. The this thing, okay, Second World War. So that we'll see in subsequent chapters. But now we have to see how the Versailles Treaty did harsh things to them. Okay, here it's not in bullet points, but you can make notes in bullet points. Okay, Germany lost its overseas colonies, a tenth of its population, 13% of its territories, 75% of its iron, and 26% of its coal to France, Poland, Denmark, and Lithuania. Okay, so these many places were lost. The Allied powers demilitarized Germany, okay, as I told. Then the War Guilt Clause, okay, there's something called War Guilt Clause, held Germany responsible for the war, okay. Actually, that's a UPSC question also, mains question, like how far do you agree that Germany was responsible for World War I and World War II? It is a UPSC question in GS1 paper, okay, I think 2016. So this kind of questions only UPSC, they won't ask directly like list down the features, list down the points. They will frame the sentences in a very difficult way, like some quote from some leader, or these kind of how do you think, what do you think, or do you agree, that kind of statements. They'll put some statement and ask you such questions. Okay, so you have to tell the perspective based on which UPSC ask. Okay, now war and damage they had to pay, okay, actually amounting to £6 billion or something they had to pay. The Allied armies also occupied the resource rich Rhineland I showed you in the map. Okay, then many Germans held the new Weimar Republic responsible for not only defeat in the war, but the disgrace at Versailles. Okay, so even though Republic was formed, people were unhappy. Okay, in detail we'll see in World War I what was the exact points of Versailles Treaty. It's not in this chapter, but now just understand, like, it was a very humiliating thing, and Germany people were dissatisfied. Effects of the war. The war had a devastating impact, obviously, World War I, on the entire continent, both psychologically and financially. From a continent of creditors, Europe turned into debtors. Okay, everybody is in debt. Unfortunately, the infant Weimar Republic was being made to pay for the sins of the old empire. Okay, so it is Germany who is paying for the entire thing. Many people fought the war, but Germany was suffering the most. So war guilt, national humiliation, financially crippled. Those who supported the Weimar Republic, mainly socialists, Catholics and Democrats, became easy targets of attack in the conservative nationalist circle. So these people who were supporting the Republic were all criticized, telling like, it is you people who are responsible for this humiliation. Okay, the mindset had a major impact on the political developments of the early 1930s, and that is what we are going to discuss in the subsequent chapters, so paragraphs. The First World War left a deep imprint on European society and polity. Soldiers came to be placed above civilians. Politicians and publics laid great stress on the need for men to be aggressive, strong and masculine. Okay, so they all emphasized on these kind of things. People has to be stronger. An army is placed above civilians. Not much information here. Then democracy was indeed a young and fragile idea which could not survive the instabilities of inter- it's totally instable there, that is what they're telling. Political radicalism and economic crisis. The birth of Weimar Republic coincided with the revolutionary uprising of the Spartacist League on the pattern of the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia. Okay, Russia, you know, that is the Bolshevik Revolution story. So along with that, this timeline coincided, and then the Spartacist League actually came here in this particular place. Now, Soviets are workers and sailors. Wait, there's a picture, okay, in between. The rally organized by that particular group, that is Spartacist League, okay, in the winter of 1918-19, the streets of Berlin was taken over by the people. Political demonstration became common, okay. So that's what I told, the timeline is coinciding with the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia, okay. And so the political atmosphere in Berlin was charged with demands for Soviet style governance, okay, that is what people demanded. Those opposed to this, such as the Socialist Democrats and Catholics, met in Weimar to give shape to a democratic republic. The Weimar Republic crushed the uprising with the help of a war veterans organization called Free Corps. Okay, so people were on the streets, so to suppress them, something called the Free Corps were formed with the war veterans. The anguished Spartacists later founded the Communist Party of Germany. Okay, so what happened is, because they are in line with the Russian ideology, it will obviously be leftist, and it is how Communist Party of Germany was formed, and to oppress them there is this free corps. Okay, understand that thing now. Now communist and socialist henceforth became irreconcilable enemies and could not make common cause against Hitler. Both evolutionaries and militant nationalists craved for radical solutions. We'll see the story of how Hitler comes into picture. Okay, here in one photograph you can see cash, okay, paper currency is being carried from the bank. Okay, German mark is the currency. Okay, German mark had so little value. So here if you see, now if you see like $1 equal to 65 rupees, 70 rupees, that time itself we people shout and create issues, right? Like our rupees getting degraded. But see here in German mark how much it fell. $1 equal to 24,000 mark, then later it became 3,53,000, then it became something like I think 4 crore 62 lakh or something. Okay, so that much bad was the exchange rate, okay, between mark and dollars. Okay, people here again queuing up for getting shelter or getting piece of bread, that kind of thing were happening. And on top of this, at this time actually USA was trying to help. Okay, here if you see, Americans intervened and bailed Germany out of the crisis by introducing a Dawes plan which reworked the terms of reparation, that is the Versailles Treaty, and problem was there, right? So USA tried to help them by forming a plan so that Germany can be pulled out of the crisis. But again, in the economy angle, try to see 1929 what will happen. The Great Depression will happen, right? Wall Street Exchange is the stock exchange of USA, okay, one of the largest in the world also. So that crashed, okay, and you know 1929 Great Depression will be there. If you don't know about that, watch my economic series, Ramesh Singh playlist is there, chapter 8 I think. Okay, in that it will be mentioned what is recession, what is inflation and all. So Great Depression will happen, then prices will again be a problem, people will not have money, and USA will pull out of that. So Germany is no longer getting any more help. Okay, German economy was the worst hit by the economic crisis. By 1932 industrial production was reduced to 40% of the 1929 level. Okay, so it is reducing that much. Workers are losing their job, number of unemployment increases, people don't have place to work or live, and it's willing to do work like that. They had placard around their neck, okay, like they are willing to do any work. If you have seen old Charlie Chaplin movies and all, in that movies these kind of situations are shown, the war situation. Okay, people are actually running around companies, or what, they're waiting for the gate to open. They'll suddenly announce like, okay, employees needed, like hourly basis, and all these people will be like, what is there, herds of sheep or something, humans are running in groups to enter that gate, because after 15 minutes or something they'll close the gate, and then only who have entered will get the work, others will be out of the gate. So that kind of situation was there. You see the picture also, sleeping on the line, people have to pay to get place to sleep, at least like this, okay, sit and sleep. To get this place itself they had to pay, that was the condition there. Okay, economic crisis created deep anxieties and fears in the people. The middle class, especially salaried employees and pensioners, saw their savings diminish when the currency lost its value. Small businessmen, the self-employed and the retailers suffered as their business got ruined. Okay, so business is not there, and this proletarianization, okay, I don't know, I can't pronounce it properly, but the meaning is like people losing their business, and then they will be reduced to the class of this labor class kind of thing. Okay, an anxiety of being reduced to ranks of the working class, okay, or worse, so or like being unemployed. So that degradation of job, right, that process is called this thing. Okay, I'm not reading it again. So only organized workers could manage to keep their heads above water, but unemployment weakened their bargaining power. Big business was in crisis. Large again, same thing they are twisting and telling. Okay, we'll go to the actual content now. So here politically also some article and all, they are telling Article 48, which gave the president the power to impose emergency. You know, India constitution polity, Lakshmikant, if you have studied, the emergency provision is actually borrowed from Germany. Okay, the declaring national emergency kind of thing, or what is it, suspending, not actually national emergency, suspending the fundamental rights during national emergency, that is actually borrowed from, that concept is borrowed from Germany, German constitution, Weimar Republic. Okay, if you have read Lakshmikant you will know that. So that, telling about that only, like such things were happening, and then we'll, so this was the situation. Now someone has to rise up, right? Like the Napoleon and all rose up in the French Revolution, someone has to rise up. Whenever crisis is there, some leader will come. So now we'll see Hitler's rise to power. The crisis in the economy, polity and society formed the background to Hitler's rise to power. In 1899 he was born in Austria actually, and Hitler spent his youth in poverty. When the First World War broke out, he enrolled for the army. acted as a messenger in the front, became a corporal, and earned medals for bravery. So he was an army man. Okay, the German defeat horrified him, and the Versailles Treaty made him furious. Obviously, everybody were frustrated. He was also one of them. In 1919, he joined a small group called the German Workers' Party. Okay, German Workers' Party. He subsequently took over the organization, so he became the leader later and renamed it as National Socialist German Workers' Party, or the Nazi Party. So that is how Nazi Party, he was a member of it after the World War I, and then named it National Socialist German Workers Party, and Nazi Party it is called. Okay, so you can see again, socialism and communism is the crux of it, or it's a theme of it, you can tell. Now 1923, Hitler planned to seize control of Bavaria, march to Berlin and capture power. So he decided to now capture places. But what happened? He failed. In 1923, he failed. He was arrested and he was even sent to jail. In jail only he will write his book and all the Mein Kampf. One book is there. You should know which book Hitler has written. Now, Nazi could not effectively mobilize popular support till the early 1930s. So, if you see, 1923 he tried but failed, but 1930 only he came back and then gathered all the army and his followers, and later it will be growing. It was during the Great Depression that Nazism became a mass movement. You see the timeline, 1929 Great Depression happened, and that is the time when all people were on the streets and they were out of money and job. This is the time when Nazism grew. So in such a situation, Nazi propaganda stirred hopes for a better future, okay, because one leader is there, one face is there, so people thought a better future will come. In 1928, the Nazi party got no more than 2.6% votes in the Reichstag, the German parliament, okay. So they tried election, they did not succeed again. By 1932, it had become the largest party with 37% votes. So if you see, within 2 years, 1930 to 1932, they became the greatest party, because that they made use of that situation where people were all suffering. Okay, they made propaganda against the government. Okay, what is propaganda? Propaganda is a specific type of message directly aimed at influencing the opinion of the people. Okay, so here if you see this hailing Hitler kind of, this is the salute they do. Okay, in Mr. India movie you would have seen Hail Mogambo kind of thing. The same kind of thing they used to do for saluting Hitler. Okay, and if you see this crowd, you can understand how powerful Hitler was. Okay, that symbol swastika, inverted swastika is their symbol, and this is the huge ground where people are there. Okay, these are all followers of Hitler. So you should know they were actually doing it frequently also. Even if they don't have any agenda, they will do this so that they can showcase the power. Okay, actually they used to photograph these things and then circulate all over the world. They wanted to show the power of Germany, because his ambition is to rule over the entire world and then build an Aryan race kind of thing. His what is a white race? He was a very big, what is a very huge racist, you can tell. We'll see the atrocities done by him in the future paragraphs. He was a powerful speaker and he had that power to build a strong nation and all, but his nature will destroy everything later. We'll see. Versailles Treaty, he wanted to restore the dignity of the German people. He promised employment. He promised to weed out the foreign influences. So everything he told, he'll make this, like now Trump is telling, right, making America great again. Same way Germany will be focusing on German, everywhere only German, German, German. No other countries, no powers, no groupings, nothing. Okay. So he devised a new style of politics, and this is again the photograph I told you. They keep holding rallies like this, and they took a lot of photographs. Everyone will be in a like army uniform kind of thing and aligned in a straight line, and red banners with the swastika, the Nazi salute, and the ritualized round of applause after the speeches were all part of this spectacle of power. That is, they wanted to showcase their power. Nazi propaganda skillfully projected Hitler as a messiah, a savior, as someone who had arrived to deliver people from the distress. Okay, so again, that is the ideology people had, and that is why he became a supreme commander, you can tell. Destruction of democracy. Now 1933, President Hindenburg offered the chancellorship. Okay, that is like the prime minister and also the highest position in the cabinet of ministers, that was offered to Hitler because of his rising power. Okay, you know, chancellor, present day chancellor, if you know, tell me in comments who is the chancellor of Germany. Okay, by now the Nazis had managed to rally the conservatives to their cause. Having acquired power, Hitler set out to dismantle the structures of democratic rule. Okay, Hitler set out to dismantle the structures of democratic rule. He went inside the system and he's again going to break that system now. A mysterious fire that broke out in the German parliament, that is in the building, a fire happened. Okay, it's mysterious fire, it is told like Hitler himself did it. Okay, building in February facilitated his move, so this helped him. Okay, the fire, this is the date, and indefinitely suspended civic rights. So obviously when something like this happened, they will declare all the, what is it, suspend all the rights, and everything is in the hands of chancellor. Okay, So that happened in this particular date, and everything, freedom of speech, press and assembly, everything is suspended. Then people were sent to concentration camps. This is actually not refugee camps, but a place where people will be like kind of held hostage, and then the whole boundary will have this electric fences and all, okay, or not electric, maybe that barbed wires kind of thing. Okay, that place is called concentration camps. Okay, so most of the people were sent to that place, and full Germany was under the control of Nazis now, and the dictatorship started actually. So democracy is over and dictatorship started in Germany. Hitler became the greatest dictator of all times. So watch, many movies are there based on his life, so you can watch it also if you want. Later Subhash Chandra Bose also will go and meet him. That is an incident we discussed in Spectrum textbook. Then special surveillance, security forces, everything was there to create, to control the things in the society. They had their secret state police, okay, which was called as Gestapo. Okay, SA is Stormtroopers. Then SD is security service, criminal police. They had all these kind of squads. Okay, Germany actually was very famous for these kind of things. The military submarines, they called the U-boats. Okay, U-boats means German submarines. They had their special kind of air force and everything. They were very strong that time, okay, under Hitler. Reconstruction. So if you see this car, this picture, Volkswagen car, you know now, okay, this was actually at that time when it was called the people's car. That means it was like in mass production, and Hitler took in charge of all these things. Like, he gave the work to some economist, and then they recreated the entire economy, you can tell. They rebuilt the entire economy by these kind of schemes. So car was there, so everybody was trying to make Germany economically viable, okay, economically rich. Okay, now again, League of Nations, you know, it was one body which was formed after World War I, but it was a failed thing because World War II also will happen. It was actually formed so that no more war happened, but you know World War II will happen. So 1933, he pulled out of it. Okay, now Trump, you know, he's coming out of all the bodies like that. This guy Hitler also came out of League of Nations in 1933. He reoccupied the Rhineland, which was actually demilitarized. He reoccupied that in 1936. Integrated Austria and Germany in 1938 under the slogan, one people, one empire, one leader. Okay. This is the slogan he gave. He then went to rest German speaking Sudetenland from Czechoslovakia. So again, places he's going in and around. So the map you will see, that will be better. No need to read all the text. So if you see here, this is the actual Germany, but the green color thing is all under German occupation. Okay, German army have moved to everywhere. If you see here, even in Tunisia it is there. And Italy's territory is separate. Okay, Italy, German is totally different things. Then this is called Greater Germany, the main one. Then other, the pink one and all are Axis powers or the supporters of Germany. So if you see, it's almost entire Europe. He could have become a single emperor, okay. And he had his ambition even to other continents as well. But by that time, World War II will happen and everything will be spoiled. Now, resources were to be accumulated through expansion of territory. In September 1939, Germany invaded Poland. This started the war with France and England. So this is actually the spark, or you can tell the reason why which it happened. World War II we will discuss in later some other chapter. But Germany actually attacked Poland, okay, for a particular reason. And then they had this agreement, like if one person is attacked, others will come to help. So France and England will come inside. Then this powers are formed. Tri-party treaty is signed between Germany, Italy and Japan. So they will be one side, that is Axis powers. And the other side obviously it will be France and England. Later USA actually did not want to come into the war. We will see that story also. So puppet regime supportive of Nazi Germany were installed in a large part of Europe. By the end of 1940, Hitler was the pinnacle of his power. So this time actually US is not there. Okay, 1939 the war started, but US is yet to enter. Now Hitler now moved to achieve his long term aim of conquering Eastern Europe. Okay, so he wanted the Eastern Europe area, and he will move towards that Soviet Union place, and he will attack Soviet Union in June 1941, which is considered as a historic blunder. Okay, this can be UPSC question. He'll ask like, why is it considered as a historic blunder? Okay, Hitler, what he went entirely to that side, eastern side. So the western front of Germany, which is near the France and Britain, it was left open, and aerial bombing happened, and eastern front to the, everything was lost. Eastern front will be lost to the Soviet armies also. Okay, it was a great blunder because of which the Hitler regime will begin to end. Okay, the Soviet Red Army inflicted a crushing and humiliating defeat on Germany at Stalingrad, After this, the Soviet Red Army hounded out the retreating German soldiers until they reached the heart of Berlin. Okay, so they were retreating. It was a big defeat for them, for Germany. Meanwhile, USA had resisted because First World War itself, a lot of things happened and they lost economy and all economic problems were there. Great Depression was there. So they did not want to commit the war. But Japan, you know, it is also in the Pacific Ocean, right? So it was expanding towards the eastern regions and also for Indochina and all, they had huge this thing. That is why Subhash Chandra was also goes and asked them for help. Okay, this Germany, Japan and all, because they were strong now. But what happened is Japan actually they did something which they should not have done. They planned attack on US naval basin, and what they did, they went and attacked US base at Pearl Harbor. There is a movie Pearl Harbor, if you can please watch it, it will be helpful. The US entered the Second World War now, and obviously the Hiroshima Nagasaki bomb thing happened, you know, right? The it's called Mission Little Boy and Fat Man. Okay, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, I think August 6th and August 9th of 1945. And by this, the World War also will come to an end, because this Hitler also will commit suicide at that time. Okay, because he lost everything that time. So these are newspaper cuttings like Hitler reported dead, iron rule in Germany, silencing the opposition. Okay, so this was the story in a very broader view. Now we have to little bit zoom into the Nazis, actual thing about Nazi. Okay, so the crimes that Nazi committed were linked to the system of belief and a set of practices. Nazi ideology was synonymous with Hitler's worldview. According to this, there was no equality between people. Okay, this is the ideology, no equality between people, but only a racial hierarchy. Okay, the blonde, blue-eyed, Nordic, German Aryans were at the top, while the Jews were located at the lowest rung. Okay, this Jews are always important because it's always in the news because of Israel-Palestine issue. So they came to be regarded as the anti-race, the arch-enemies of the Aryans. Okay, Jews were considered as anti-race and enemies of the Aryans. So this was happening. It's not like only Jews, but even the blacks or other people who did not look like them, they are all treated as lower class. Okay, and you know this Herbert Spencer gave this theory of survival of the fittest. Okay, it was actually given by Herbert Spencer, and also you know Darwin's theory of this thing, natural process of selection. Okay, so these kind of things they used to justify this kind of thing, like only the fittest should survive. Okay, so again, right side, if you see small box are there, not very important. This is actually from the Hitler's books. Okay, Hitler's work, they have taken whatever he feels, his mentality, they are just showing the cuttings, but you know how the mentality is just by reading this text itself. So Nazi argument was simple: the strongest race would survive and weak one would perish. So same like Darwin's and Herbert Spencer's theory. Okay, they felt like Aryan race was the finest, retained purity, stronger, and they should have the right to dominate the world. That is what they believed in. Okay, so this was Hitler's ideology, to expand more and more territories, and just their population should be there everywhere. So that was what they wanted. Then establishing a racial state, like Nazis quickly began to implement their dream of creating an exclusively racial community of pure Germans by physically eliminating all those who they seen as undesirable. That is what they termed undesirable, these kind of people. Okay, so your picture also, you can see people are escorting gypsies who are being deported to some place. Okay, so gypsies is actually kind of a group which has its origin in India. Okay, that you should know, gypsies has its origin in India. Now again, the same thing, they'll be like talking again about the same thing. They were widely persecuted. Okay, many gypsies were also there, blacks were there. Everyone who was living in Nazi Germany, they were considered below the superior Aryan race, and they had to leave places, or they'll be either killed or they'll be deported, something, or they'll escape. Okay, they'll escape to different continents. Even to India, many Jews have come. So you know that things. And they were actually stereotyped as killers of the Christ and all. So they used to make different reasons just to terminate all these people. Okay, and 1933-38, the Nazis terrorized, pauperized, that is totally like in economically weak, and segregated the Jews, compelling them to leave the country. So they will make up situations in such a way that Jews has to forcefully go away, because if you tell like you will be killed or your money will be taken away, obviously you will leave the place, right? So that is what was happening. And there were gas chambers. Okay, I'll show you the picture after some time. They had this train coaches kind of thing where people were put inside and then gas will be released and people will be suffocated and dying. Okay, so that much it was atrocious, you can tell. Now racial utopia, again same story they are telling again and again. We don't have to read it. I'll show you. This is actually, I think, the picture. Okay, the coach. Okay, freight cars used to deport Jews to the death chambers. Okay, so it is preserved somewhere, maybe in some museum or something. Okay, this is again one big box explaining the whole story, how they used to do. Okay, persons of Germany, they were like the Jews. Okay, they were many restrictions were placed. Marriages were banned between Jews and Germans. Extramarital relations were punishable. They could not even fly the national flag. Okay, many things were done boycotting Jewish business. From government service, they were thrown away. Then selling and confiscation of properties. Okay, they were forced to sell their properties. One term you have to know, synagogue. Okay, it was in news recently. Synagogues is actually a place of worship for people of Jewish faith. Because, suppose UPSC asks a question like synagogues refers to what? You should know it is a Jewish place of prayers. Okay. So again, this kind of thing was happening. These are different symbols. Actually, this symbol, this one, if you see, it's like this particular C is some bathing resort or something. Okay, here it is free of Jews. Okay, this Juden free, if you see here, it means like this place is free of Jews. So you can come here, like the Aryan race. That is what, that much humiliation was there. Okay, and here also people were like, they didn't know what to do. They had to. And this, there's a thing, ghettos is actually the place where they went and have to settle. Okay, it's a kind of place. Then people don't have any occupation, no right to live, then diseases. Totally, you can understand all these things, hopefully. So, annihilation. This is the barbed wires I told you. Okay, and if you see, cloths outside the gas chamber, and this is shoes outside the gas chamber. Like before being killed, there maybe cloths or shoes and everything was taken away. Okay, so this is the just before the final thing. Okay, before they die. And here also, if you see, a concentration camp, a camera can make a death camp look beautiful. Okay, this place, like lakhs of people died, but if you see this picture, you will feel like it's just a beautiful kind of place. Okay, so that is what they're telling. Now, youth in Nazi Germany, again, this Hitler promoted this school and Nazi kind of schools where their ideology will be promoted. Again, other children were not allowed. They were made to sit outside, or they will be thrown out, or they will be finally killed also. So, schools were there just to kind of purify the ideology of minds from the young age itself. Like, it's told like, even before they could learn to speak, they were given the Nazi flag in their hands. Okay, so that kind of ideology it was. Jews were segregated, so it's again telling full stories, because he actually wanted a lot of youth. You saw that crowd, right? That huge army kind of people, everybody is youth only. He promoted a lot of youth into his this thing, into his Nazi camp. Okay, here if you see a junk walk. Okay, this is actually Nazi youth groups for children below 14 years of age. So like that, they had group and all, and later it will be organized to something, Nazi youth organization, Hitler youth. Many names are there. Then Youth League of the Nazis was founded in 1922. So like this, youth were in huge numbers. Just to tell that point, they are telling pages and pages. Here these are again pictures. This two on the right, you see, these are actually Jewish child who will be actually killed. Okay, and if you see this picture on this coat, you see a star kind of shape, right, where I'm keeping the cursor. This is actually, they were forcefully asked to wear, okay, yellow star kind of thing to identify like he is a Jew. Okay, and he will be caught and killed. The other one, left side, if you see, these pictures are like the Aryan race kind of children. Okay, so here he wanted them to grow up and then again multiply, and this race should be there all over the world, dominating the world. This again, small kid is actually again this thing, German blood. Okay, so these people were not done anything, they were considered superior, and others were killed, whether it's children or women, everybody were killed. Again, Nazi cult of motherhood. Hitler used to say like motherhood is the most important thing, or most what is it? Here I think it's there. In my state, the mother is the most important citizen. Okay, he said this, but he, you know, like if it is a Jew person or some other black person, he doesn't care. Okay, he'll be killing all of them. So he's contradicting his own statement. That is what they are telling about the cult of motherhood under Hitler. Okay, art of propaganda. Nazi regime used language and media with care and often to great effect. The terms they coined to describe their various practices are not only deceptive, they are chilling. Nazis never used the words kill or murder in their official communication. Okay, mass killings were termed special treatment, final solution for the Jews. Euthanasia, you know, euthanasia, like killing people. Euthanasia for the disabled, selection and disinfection. So these kind of terms they use. They never used kill or murder in the official language and media communication. Okay, so again, gas chamber story I told you. So this is how they did. They killed a lot of people. That is why Hitler was considered as the greatest dictator, or the most unbearable person of that time. People are killed in this huge numbers, which has never happened in history and which will never happen also. And these are actually posters, nothing much to read here. I'll tell you, this is actually Jews people. They are telling like they are too much greedy and money minded people, and until they get this kind of big sack full of money, they will not rest. Okay, so they are telling propaganda, they are spreading fake propagandas like Jews are undesirable and not fit. Okay, this is actually attacking the Jews, this poster. Then again, farmers, some poem kind of thing is there, we don't need to read. Maybe I can tell you the German farmer stands in between the two great dangers. That is, we know that American capitalism was happening and the Marxist Bolshevism, that is the Russian thing, was happening. So these were in between. Okay, so Jews also had this problem, like people did not know where to go, why to go, or how to proceed in life. About the ordinary people also, we discussed everything. They have just given in small chapters the gist, everything. I think while telling the story itself, I told you. And one major thing here they are telling is about the people did not ever try to resist. Okay, because Nazi, everyone went and joined this Nazi thing, Nazi party or Nazi follower they became, but they did not unite, because personally, like suppose there are people within the Aryan race who is not able to bear this, but they are not doing anything. Okay, they are not doing anything for the improvement of the society or helping out these people. Okay, so this kind of poem kind of thing. First they came for the communist, but I am not a communist, so I did not do anything. Then they came for the social democrat, I was not a social democrat, so did nothing. Then again trade unionist, I am not that, so I didn't do. Then again Jews, I am not Jew, I also did not do. Then finally they came for me, but there was no one left who could stand up for me. Okay, so when others were in problem, you did not go, and now you are in problem, nobody else is left because everybody is already dead, right? So that kind of one poem kind of thing somebody has written. Okay, again this is one milk can actually, which was recovered, which was actually buried under the ground. People left letters, I think the inhabitants of that Warsaw is a place in Poland, you know, Warsaw ghetto, that place where they stayed, they had collected documents and placed them in three milk cans along with the other containers. So people feared like it will be destroyed, so they buried it, and later it was discovered, the letters and things with which people know, historians know about the sufferings of the people. Okay, so that is about this the milk can. Then again there are other countries who tried to help. Actually I think this boat which you see the picture, it is actually Denmark secretly rescued the Jews from Germany. Okay, so this is one of the boat. Okay, so there were other countries who were trying to help, but it was not too much success. Okay, so this is what this chapter totally tells, and it is ending with the Mahatma Gandhi's letter to Hitler. You know, Mahatma Gandhi was forced by all other leaders to write letter, because only Hitler was the person who could stop the war. So it is in 1939, before the war began. Okay, so he's telling very polite way kind of thing. You know Mahatma Gandhi, how he'll speak, it'll be like I am sorry to ask this, I am sorry to say this, I hope I did not bother you, that kind of what is a very appeasing kind of language he has written. But finally what he's telling is, you are the only one who can stop the war, and humanity problems and all will not come if you stop this war, so please, again he's telling, anticipate your forgiveness, I have word in writing to you. So this kind of thing he wrote, obviously no reaction will be there. And again one more letter is there, 1940, he wrote like non-violence is not according to my policies. And then what is that? Again, a few things. Okay, I hope you will know. If you want, you can pause and read. Not important for our exam. So, you should know Gandhi had tried to do something. Okay, and he is also telling like doing all these things will maybe give you territories, but no one will remember you after your death or something like that. That is the gist of this. Okay, so don't do anything for anything against humanity. Okay, this is not a complete letter, but they have just put some text for our understanding. These questions, if you can answer, then that means you know at least the story of German Revolution. Okay, Nazi Revolution, you can tell. That is one thing. But UPSC will not ask you this kind of straight questions like explain this, list down this and all. I will show you some UPSC questions which I took from the UPSC website. Okay. To what extent can Germany be held responsible for causing the two world wars? This was the recent question. So they are asking you a holistic thing about Germany thing in the 1914 and 1940. Okay, UPSC is expecting you to understand all things and then write a 150 word answer for 12.5 marks. So they have stopped asking question directly about one theme. Every question you take, there will be comparison. Okay, if you take the Indian history also, they will be like compare the Kushanas with the Guptas, or compare the Rigvedic period with the later Vedic period. They want to ask maximum things in one single question. Okay, that is why UPSC exams are always tough to complete in the given time limit. So you also have to prepare this way. Okay, we are not going to discuss here now. The answers will be discussed in the history answer writing series, which I'll start after some time. But now we have to complete the portions and understand the contents. Okay, so this is just a beginning. NCRT, just a walkthrough of world history. Specific world history videos maybe later we'll do, or at least I'll tell you the sources how to do it. And answer writing will anyway be done, so you'll be able to complete it. One more question we'll see. Do you agree with the view that the Treaty of Versailles was a bad compromise between a treaty based upon force and a treaty based upon ideas? So again, that how humiliating it was. Okay, so that context again, world history, when you World War One, when you learn, you will get more points. But I wanted to show you these two questions so that UPSC's mindset you can understand. Okay, if you have not seen the question papers yet. Okay, so these are all 2016 and 15 questions only. So you should know this is how questions are framed. Again, I'll show you in every chapter what kind of questions actually comes, so that you will be ready at least for preparation. You should not be shocked when you start the answer writing yourself. Okay, so this is about this chapter. I'll come up with the next chapter soon. So till then, thank you and have a nice day.